Hello students, we'll start with the next session of applications of enzyme, and this video lecture deals with the analytical applications of enzymes. So enzymes as analytical agents. So because of the sensitivity and specificity of enzymes makes them useful tools in medicine for the detection and measurement of chemicals in fluids such as blood and urine. So because of their specificity, enzymes will bind only to the substrate. They can therefore be used for identification of a specific substance in a biological sample. So because of their sensitivity, enzymes are able to detect the presence of the specific molecules even when they are present at very low concentration. Application of first enzyme, it is the application of glucose oxidase. So glucose oxidase, it is applied for the detection of the glucose in the biological samples, where glucose oxidase catalyzes the conversion of glucose into gluconic acid. So this is a photo of similar to your biosensors, okay, where enzyme is when the blood sample is given or the blood sample is dropped, the amount of glucose present in the blood can be visualized in the form of digits, okay, where it is sensed by the transducer and it shows the amount of glucose present in the digital form. Glucose oxidase is widely used coupled with a peroxidase reaction that visualizes colorimetrically the formed H2O2 for the determination of free glucose in serum or blood plasma for diagnostic. Using spectrometric assays manually or with automated procedures and even with a point of use of rapid assays, glucose oxidase is used as an analytical tool for the determination of amount of free glucose. Glucose oxidase is widely used for the determination of free glucose in the body fluids, medical testing and in vegetal raw material and in food industry. It has also many applications in biotechnology. Typically, the enzyme assay for biochemistry, including biosensors in the nanotechnologies, this enzyme is used. It was first isolated by Delva Muller in 1928 from Aspergillus niger. Glucose, it is converted into gluconolactone by the reaction of glucose oxidase, and gluconolactone plus hydrogen peroxide with the chromogen, a colorless chemical, by the reaction of peroxidase, it will be converted into a dark color compound. The concentration of this dark color compound indicates the amount of glucose present. See, this is the color reading exactly after 30 seconds where the sample was given, okay. If the color in the the paper strip or in the kit, if it appears a slight bluish color, it is negative. If the color changes like this, then gradually, so the color, if it is a light green, it is 100 milligrams per dl, and it is 250 if the color changes a little bit darker green, and it is 500 milligrams per dl, so it is a color of algae, like algae greenish color, and light reddish if it is 1000 milligrams per dl, and the dark reddish, it gives the result about 2000 milligrams per dl. So this is how the result is inferred if the free inferred in the biological samples if it is tested with glucose oxidase. The next enzyme is urease. In clinical biochemistry, urease is applied as a diagnostic for the clinical condition by determining the various constituents of different body fluids. The determination can be qualitative or quantitative. Quantitative determination of urea and creatinine in the blood and urine help in the assessment of kidney functioning, or determination of inorganic substance like sodium, potassium, calcium, chloride, etc. Or maybe the enzymes are hormones in order to diagnose the disease by many methods, as manual kit, or sometimes it is automated. The urease was found in numerous bacteria, fungi, algae, plants and some vertebrates, as well as in soils as a soil enzyme. So they are nickel containing metalloenzymes of high molecular weight. To treat hypertension, this urease is obtained from Cucumis mello is a source of urease enzyme that shows the diuretic effects in herbal medicines. These diuretic clinical medicines are used to lower blood pressure and work by increasing the excretion of urine from the body as well as the amount of sodium in the urine. So the urease, it has been estimated that these metabolic products of urease activity stress cancer cells by direct toxicity and by induction of alkaline effects. Ammonia is toxic to cancer cells, and catabolism of urea increases the local pH of the surrounding media. This is how the urea kit is available in the market. The mechanism of reaction is urea is converted into ammonia and carbon dioxide by the action of urease, and this ammonia, it is converted into glutamic acid, that is amino group is transferred into the that oxaloglutarate to form glutamic acid. So the enzyme is glutamate dehydrogenase. So this is the kit available in the market for detection of the urea by urease enzyme. The next analytical enzyme is cholesterol oxidase. Enzymatic blood cholesterol kit, it is also available in the market to estimate or to check the amount of this cholesterol present. Okay, cholesterol esterase, the precursor of this cholesterol, where it is converted into cholesterol by cholesterol esterase. The cholesterol is converted into cholesterol oxidase, and this the product, that is cholesterol-4-NO3-enone, it reacts with, where this compound, it forms along with this compound is estimated by the amount of the fluorescence exited by this compound by using a fluorescence probe. So the amount of fluorescence is directly proportional to this compound. So it is a precursor of this cholesterol ester, that is the amount of cholesterol present in the blood sample. So this, for this, the enzyme, that's hydrogen HRP, it is a harsh radice peroxidase, it is used to catalyze H2O2. The same reaction I have given here. Cholesterol ester, it is converted into cholesterol. That cholesterol is degraded by a ketone compound by cholesterol oxidase, and this ketone, it forms compounds with ample red. So that gives a resource fin compound, that is gives a fluorescence, what I explained in the last slide. And this, it is catalyzed by harsh radice peroxidase, and H2O is converted into water. So this is amplex red compound. When it is oxidative conversion, it is converted into a colorful compound that is going to be estimated in the estimation of cholesterol present in the biological samples. This cholesterol oxidase, it is applied in various tests. The first one, it acts as a bad catalyst for steroid transformation. And this enzyme, again, it has a clinical application for cholesterol estimation, and it is also has a role in biocontrol of insect. It is also used in biosensor for fabrication of analytical applications. And this cholesterol oxidase, it also has the antifungal agent by polyene macrolytic pimericin biosynthesis, and potential new antimicrobial drug target. And it is has a role in cell membrane structural studies. Cholesterol oxidase has been used in biocatalysts for the production of number of steroids. It has an insecticidal protein against the boll weevil larvae. It is a diagnostic enzyme for determination of serum levels of cholesterol. So these applications prompted various laboratories worldwide to isolate this flavooxidase from different sources and to improve its properties by protein engineering. The commercial cholesterol biosensor is also available. It has a third generation of cholesterol biosensors, use direct electron transfer between the enzymes and the electrodes. In the absence of a mediator, the distance between the immobilized enzyme and the immobilized enzyme and the electrode should be as small as possible. Such biosensors are now available, then they are more sensitive. A wide range of cholesterol biosensors are available in the market today using a range of matrix immobilization and transducer technology. This is an electrode, okay, the semiconducting carbon nanotube, which detects the amount of cholesterol, and it is displayed in the form of digital units. The next enzyme is lipase. As you all know, that lipase acts on lipids to release glycerol and free fatty acids. Primarily, this lipase marketed for therapeutic purpose as a diagnostic enzyme to supplement the pancreatic lipase in the digestive disorders. Since free fatty acids affect the odor and taste of cheese, and the cheese ripening process is also affected by lipases, microbial concentration affects during the aging process can be due to the lipase action. So in the soap industry, lipase from Candida cylindricea is used to hydrolyze the oils. So lipase reaction mechanism faction is given here. It is triacyl glycerol undergoes hydrolysis by the action of lipase to release glycerol and free fatty acid. So other applications of lipase are, they are used in the food industry, food aroma and flavor enhancement, synthesis of natural dyes, flavors and emulsifiers. So it is also used in the paper industry, textile, leather industry, and removal of hydrophobic substance. And lipase is also applied in the environmental bioremediation treatment of effluents and industrial waste, and pharmaceutical and medical separation of enantiomers and production of biosensors. And the lipase enzyme is also used in the biofuel and biodiesel production, and it is also applied in the chemical ester synthesis, production of detergents and emulsifiers, production of polymers. Analytical applications of catalase. Another enzyme is catalase. It is produced from bovine liver and microbial source. So it has a role in the breakdowning the hydrogen peroxide to water and molecular oxygen. Along with the glucose oxidase, it is used in treating the food wrappers to prevent oxidation. It is also used to remove the traces of hydrogen peroxide in the process of cold sterilization. Catalase also used in food industry. It is also used in the food industry for removing hydrogen peroxide from milk prior to cheese production, and removing hydrogen peroxide from fabrics to make sure that material is peroxide free to prevent browning. Analytical applications of protease. Proteases are used in biofilm removal. It is also used in fibrin clot dissolution, nematode control. Protease also has application in wool biopolishing, prion degradation. Prions are protein infective agents. Okay, protease also used in photographic industry, leather industry, food industry, processing of keratin residues in the meat industry, and also in the contact lens cleaning in detergent industry and silk degumming. These are the other applications of protease. So in the leather industry, protease along with the lipase are mainly used for soaking, baking, and enzyme assisted unhairing, that is removal of hair. And protease are also used. This is the name of the company where is a major supplier of enzyme to the leather industry in India and across the globe. And it is one of the oldest application of enzymes in the industry, is the processing of hides and skins of animals for leather industry. Another enzyme is pectinase. Pectinase is used for clarification of juices, where the fruits are fermented or fruits are processed for the production of fruit juice. After peeling and de-seeding, it is blended with food blenders for the color, aroma and taste, and is filtered using cheesecloth. It is concentrated juice. It is treated with an enzyme pectinase for clarification. This is the difference between unclarified juice and clarified juice. So other analytical applications of enzymes are, it is used in the animal feed industry, meat and fish processing industry, dairy industry, leather industry, and cleaning microfilters, modification of fats and oils, pulp and paper industry, fruit juice processing industry, and production of bulk and fine chemicals. And it is also used in, the enzymes are also used in enzyme replacement therapy. So this is about the analytical applications of enzymes. Okay, thank you for watching. Keep watching and stay safe. Thank you.